Hey guys, I'm here to talk about creatine and hair loss. The most common form of hair loss is male pattern baldness. It looks something like this. Not everyone loses their hair in the same way, but if you know it's coming and you fancy a quick bout of depression, you can check out something like the Norwood scale. This kind of hair loss is genetic and it has to do with something called DHT. DHT is a byproduct of testosterone and it can bind to the receptors in your hair follicles, and through a process called miniaturization, it makes the hair follicle shrink, giving you that much coveted thinning hair look until the follicle is so small that the hair is practically invisible. DHT is only a problem if you have the genes that predispose you to male pattern baldness in the first place. There are guys out there with lots of DHT in their system and a full head of hair because they don't have the gene that triggers that mechanism in the hair follicle. So what has all this got to do with creatine? Well, DHT is a more active form of testosterone, and one of the ways that creatine works is by converting more of your testosterone into DHT, which helps with building muscle. The study that started all this saw a group of rugby players take creatine monohydrate for 3 weeks. They followed the protocol on the label, which is 1 week loading phase of 25 grams, followed by 2 weeks of 5 grams a day as maintenance. In the loading phase, their DHT levels went up 56%, and then in the maintenance phase, they dropped a little to 40% above baseline. It takes a few weeks for creatine to completely go out your system, and by that time you would imagine that their DHT levels return to normal. That means if you are genetically predisposed to male pattern baldness, then creatine is likely to accelerate that process by boosting your DHT levels. It's going to do this while you're taking creatine and for a few weeks after until it's out your system. If like me, you are not aware of this, it can be quite frustrating to find out, because I was blissfully unaware while cycling creatine from about the age of 17 through to 22. I decided to stop taking it because while I've accepted that I'm going to lose my hair, I have no desire to make that happen any sooner. There are drugs like finasteride and minoxidil that block DHT, but they also block some of the positive effects it has, so it isn't as glorious as Homer makes it look. From reading some of the online reviews, it seems a lot of people regret taking these things because of the side effects, like absolutely tanking their sex drive. Personally, I don't like it, but I've accepted it, and I suggest you work through the stages of grief and join me in acceptance. You don't need to go around wearing t-shirts like this, but if losing your hair is one of your biggest problems right now, then you've got a pretty good life. Thanks for watching.